Today is all about speed transitions in Final Cut Pro, and we're just going to dive in because nobody knows what it is. In this example, we've divided our clip into three different speeds: 153%, 42%, and 141%. It will jump from 153% to 42% in one frame. But let's say we want to change the speed over a longer time. That's where speed transitions come in. To add transitions between all the speed segments, select the clip, then select the Retime menu below the viewer, and click on Speed Transitions. And look at that. Those little boxes are the length of the speed transitions. Here's the difference between the original and the version with the transitions added. It's very subtle, but the transitions make the changes in speed a bit more smooth. Here's another helpful workaround if you're interested. We can change the duration of the transition by dragging its edge left or right. So if we make this transition shorter, it will make the speed change more abrupt. The longer the transition, the slower and more gradual the speed will change. If we want to delete an individual transition, we'll just need to double-click this icon and deselect the speed transition checkbox. Then, click anywhere outside the box to dismiss it. The transition is now removed. And if we want to remove transitions for all speed ramps at once, select the whole clip and navigate to the Retime menu. Click on the Speed Transitions option so that the check mark is removed. As you can see, the transitions are no longer there. If you'd like to learn how to make your footage buttery smooth when doing slow-mo, check out the Optical Flow and Frame Blending tutorial in the description below. Speed transitions are now a piece of cake, yeah. Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level. Hey everybody, like, share, subscribe if you're looking for more education on Final Cut Pro.